what's right. Fight for your life. When it comes crashing down and it hurts inside, you gotta take a stand and don't have to hide. If you hurt my friends, then you hurt my pride. I gotta be a man, I can't let it slide.
I am a real American, fight for the rights of every man. I am a real American, fight for what.
Oh, you better believe it. What's going on, people? That's right. Tom Steele's left. We got Lisa in the house tonight. Yeah, Lisa, what's going on, babe? Lisa, your eyes are all sparkly and everything. Holy cow, folks, what's going on? I'm telling you, it's Tom Shields Live, the Tom and Lisa show. That's right. What do? We complain, but we like to have fun, too. We just don't. Let me get you up here, Lisa. I always, let me see if we got you here. Look at that. The first shot, I got you right up next to me. People, what's going on? Let's see if we sound great. Here you are. All right. Looks like we're sounding great because no one is complaining. Lisa, how's it going?
Great.
Is it? Are you? Your eyes are really sparkly with the lights and everything. That's kind of nice. Oompa Loompa came on. I wondered where he was. What's going on, everybody? Oompa Loompa. I mean, Oompa Loompa had a couple drinks. I wish I could have hung around a little more, but I had my ball and chain. I mean, I had... No. No. Everything was good. Everything was good. Oh, man, I'm telling you, we've still got the music on. We always let the music go a little more, just like just like any other show. You got the music going, you know, and people are saying, well, what is this all about, Minnesota? What's going on? Well, I'm looking over to my left here because we are an internet television program, and you're probably saying, well, Tom, can we have the website, please? And I'm like, well, there you go. Go check out the website. It is a live program. It is 9:04 on the East Coast, which means it is 6:04 on the West Coast, and it is whatever time, wherever you are, mountain time, whatever else. Just kind of judge it by East Coast, West Coast, and then you're mixed in the middle. And we still got music going? Yes, we do. So, Lisan, what's up? You had your book signing the other Saturday. Oh, that's not a problem. Was it Saturday? Yeah, that was Saturday.
Saturday night.
Man, time goes by fast. Oh, the book signing, everybody was there. We all had it. I wish I had to go grocery shopping, so I had to leave a little early. That I was taken out by, I had to go, and I had to go buy groceries. But I wish I could have stayed a little more, because I guess you guys had a little fun afterwards.
Oh, we had a great time.
What, they have a DJ or something?
Yeah, they had a DJ, and before you know it, we were all dancing. And my son calls at like 12:30 at night, and he's like, Dad, where are you? This is outrageous. It's so late.
Were those dance instructors, the two cute ones,
absolutely,
were they there? And they hung around later? And they were dancing?
Yeah. And they're incredible dancers.
Ah.
You know who's a great dancer, too?
Who?
Is Amy behind the glass.
Really?
She can really work.
Amy looks great. I haven't seen Amy in a while. But she looks really good.
Yeah, she was working it. And Zura's mom was there.
That's right. Zura's mom was there. And I had to leave early.
And everybody missed you. Everybody was like, oh, I wish Tom
really?
Hung out and party. Oh, everybody did.
Oh, you know, I like to mingle. I'm a kind of guy that likes to talk to people. Mm-hmm. I like to get involved. I like to network. And it just so happens that the other half or whatever is a little bit different than that. I like to make new friends. I like to, you know, this and that. But what are you going to do? I'm telling you, folks, there is a lot going. Actually, is there a lot going on in the world? Is there, like, crazy? It's just the same old pain in the ass Obama that keeps making these rotten decisions and has to. Is the Congress going to pass the American Jobs Bill? The American Jobs Bill? He has to put that title on it. And folks, I'm sure you realize he puts that title on it because if Congress doesn't pass it, how could they not pass something called the American Jobs Bill, no matter what's in it?
It's the Senate that won't even bring it up for a vote because even the Democrats don't want to pass that bad bill.
Yeah.
And they don't even want to talk about it because it's not the Republicans in Congress. It's the Senate Democrats who are like, whoa,
you know,
this
and
thing is terrible.
It doesn't it exhaust you? Like my heart isn't even beating well because of all the crap that spins around. What's that song we even have there? Round and round. It just goes round and round. That's all it does. There's never a change. It's the same old, over and over again. What's that song by The Temptation? It's the same old song. It's it. You ever hear, is that, or is that the Four Tops? Someone might know. I might be wrong. Even though I'm a DJ, it's a different meaning since you've been gone. It's the same old song.
We should make another song. It's the same old loans. From one solar company to...
Let me tell you, speaking of loans and people defaulting on loans, Bank of America, I mean, I know everyone's like, is this a news show? Is it a funny thing? It's well, what is it something we're going to laugh at? You can laugh with us or you can laugh at us. It all depends. And people are probably saying, Tom, when you look forward, it really doesn't look like you're looking straight at the camera. Well, I have a little monitor off to the right, and I like to make sure that... things are looking good, you know what I mean? So
they look fantastic.
At first, I thought Perry was going to be okay. No more. He's a friend of the illegals. What a mess. Let me tell you, Mr. Naturopathy, I was high on Perry, too, until the last debate when he looked like... he just looked like a big goof standing up there.
He really did.
He looked like he just had no knowledge of how to defend himself. You know when you were young in school and you were inexperienced and the bigger, smarter kid kind of picked on you a little bit and you were a little dumb, like you were sitting there like, abada, abada, abada. That's what he looked like, someone that was ill-prepared and that he really didn't know how to defend himself.
Yeah, he looked taken aback, like,
yeah.
Do I have to defend myself?
Yeah. Okay. How dare I? I'm the, you know, Rick Perry, I'm a handsome man, you know? I mean, you know, handsome only gets you so far. Take it from me. No. I don't know why. I make fun of myself. That's why, you know, we have fun here. I don't take everything too seriously. I make fun of myself. I'm giving up, Tommy. Mr. Naturopathy, don't do it, babe. Don't do it. We got to stay strong. Us Tea Party conservatives have to stay strong.
Absolutely.
Do you consider yourself a Tea Party person?
I'm a total Tea Party.
Are you a teetotaler?
Oh, absolutely. I'm a tea bagger.
Whoa, Oompa Loompa! No, let me see.
I know, that sounds terrible, but you know what? I'm not ashamed. I support the Tea Party. I support lower taxes. I support personal responsibility. And I'm not ashamed to say it.
Exactly.
You know, I'm not ashamed. Don't try to label me.
You're
no
a
labels,
hard worker.
No labels.
No labor group.
No labels.
You're a hard worker. You put
Absolutely.
Together. You sat down and wrote that book. You sat down on your own time without any help. It was your idea. You put it together and you worked hard at it. You created a book signing. You put that together. You had to rent the room. You had invitations, Facebook messages, everything else. You had to create. You created something. How powerful is that for you to create something that happens? That's what I always tell people. All right, they say, oh, this is a little internet show. I'm not sure if I really care, you know, this and that. Let me tell you something. I created something. I created something out of nothing. I wanted to have a show. I wanted to express my views about what's going on
That's
in the world.
Right.
I may not hold a Harvard degree, but I still wanted to get
That's
on the
right.
air, even if it's a very small audience, to tell people how I feel. And I feel that my thoughts and ideas generate through the community. I believe that I'm representing people who are middle class America, people who are the hard working man that gets out there, really doesn't get his voice heard. Well, I get out there and I tell it like it is. I may not have the diction, I may not be as articulate as you see on the big screen or anything else, but I'll tell you what, we get our message across.
And and you don't have a teleprompter.
No.
Where some fancy speechwriter writes everything down for you.
Exactly.
Perfect. It comes from the heart.
60 minutes, Lisa, mm-hmm. we do this. 60 minutes.
Right.
Do you think it's scripted? It's not scripted.
Not at all.
What, we write down a couple of ideas? Mm-hmm. You see me reading from anything? This isn't scripted. This is passion, baby. When I talk about how I'm disgusted with the government, when I talk about how I'm disgusted with mm-hmm. the liberal ideas of how to get this economy moving, when I tell you I'm disgusted on President Obama and all the things that he does with his inexperience, when I talk about that, it's because it's passion, because I'm out there working every day, I'm paying my taxes, and my tax dollars are going to muffins that the freaking government, they're going to, you're going to have a get together in the White House? I'll tell you what, if we're going to get together in the White House, the hell with everybody else, order the muffins that are $16 a piece, and I'll tell you what, order 200 muffins that are $16 a piece because we're not paying for it. We're using other people's money. Right here, why don't you kiss
That's
my
cute.
Big fat white rear end? You know, come
That's
on.
That's true. I could have never had a book party if I had to spend
$16
a muffin.
Why didn't you get $16 muffins or $25 cupcakes?
Because
why didn't you?
I had to feed my family.
That's right. That's what
to
me and
it.
You have to That's what me and you have to think about.
It's true.
Is paying the bills and feeding our families. But I tell you what, that's not what they think over at the White House. That's not what government thinks because they spend other people's money. They're sickening.
Mm-hmm.
All politicians make me sick to my stomach. I'd like to have a preference. I'd like to respect a politician, but the more I hear mm-hmm. and the more I see makes me sick $16 muffins.
I know. It's absolutely ridiculous. Where's George Washington? When
and there might be some people watching now. $16 muffins? What's you're not watching The Daily Show, all right? We talk if we're talking about $16 muffins, we know what we're talking about, Jon Stewart.
Yeah.
Did you see Bill O'Reilly was on Jon Stewart mentioned he was on The Daily Show, Bill O'Reilly.
Oh, really?
And he mentioned the $16 muffins. Took Jon Stewart totally by surprise. He had no idea.
Really?
But, you know, a lot of people don't know. Go on Google and find out. Mm-hmm. Put down $16 muffins, and I'm sure somebody wrote an article already.
True story.
How the White House reacts and how government reacts. I'm not too sure what the get-together was or what function they were having.
They have a function like every day.
Yeah, I just know that government politicians ordered 16 frickin' dollar muffins. We got, who knows our phone number? We don't even have it up yet. This phone wasn't working before, and I hope it's. Something's wrong. I can't get the speakerphone to work.
Uh-oh.
I know.
That
sucks.
I hear something.
I know, but we're having. All right, I don't know who's calling in, and I feel bad. We for some reason the speakerphone on this piece of crap phone is not working. The phone is working, we heard it ring, but the mm-hmm. speakerphone isn't working, and if the speakerphone isn't working, then we can't get you on the air.
Sorry about that.
Son of a B. And here's the phone number too, but why should I post
because
it?
Because all the phones are made of crap now.
All right, here we go. Let's see what we got here. We might be able to work this out. Oh, hello, how can I help you? Hello? Who's this?
Charlie.
Charlie, what's up, man? What's going on?
Charlie.
How much? How are you doing?
I don't know. We're trying to see if we can get you on the microphone here.
Oh.
We got you, Charlie.
I just tried calling the other line.
Yeah, the other line. There's something wrong with it. I can't figure out. We can't get you on speakerphone on the other line.
Oh, gotcha.
Oh, we got you loud and clear on this line. Charlie, what's going on, man? You want to order some
I don't know much. Hanging out at Oktoberfest, drinking some gum and beer, you know, having some fun.
Well, you know, hey, if you want to have some more fun, why don't you order some muffins that cost $16 a piece?
Mm-hmm. Well, I might just do that.
All right, Charlie, you're not at home, are you?
No, I'm not.
Where are you, at the local tavern?
No, I'm just actually down at a little fair thing called the Oktoberfest.
Oh, all right.
Oh, Oktoberfest.
Oktoberfest.
It's September.
That's all right, October Saturday.
Here, you know, and, yeah.
All right, Charlie, well, I'll tell you what.
He sounds like he's at October.
It sounds like you're having a good time. We're going to let you go and keep on rolling. But, Charlie, thanks for calling.
I'm going to make sure you hear recorded, though. That's all.
All right, baby.
Bye, Charlie.
All right.
We miss you.
Charlie, we'll see you in a little bit, babe. Take it easy.
Good.
We love you, man. Bye-bye.
I love you too, man.
That
there we go.
That is so funny.
See, Charlie's not even home, mm-hmm. but he gave us a buzz just to say he's thinking about it.
Thank you, Charlie.
Huh? Let me see if I got the audience on. See, I'm right on top of things. What's going on, people? I tell you what, the Stick Network is always taking care of us.
Yay.
I appreciate that. Let me check the button here, because I know I'm going to be very happy probably in about 3 seconds. 1, 2, 3. Well, not extremely happy, but I'm still happy. I'm still, you know, those guys know I'm just a kidder. Oh, man, oh, man. You know, a long time ago when we were on, they said, never mind.
Let me ask you, did John Stewart eat his humble pie when he heard about the $16 muffins?
He was taken back. He was taken back. But he still has the ability and the talent to make it look like he's defending himself and he's going to be okay. He's got that talent. He's a talented guy. I mean, look, he's making the big money, and we're here in a little studio in.
Well, that's because nobody would like us in the entertainment industry.
Because we tell it like it is.
Exactly.
We don't take any bribes from anybody. Mm-hmm. But I'll tell you what, if anybody wants to come along and say, hey, here's a couple of average people that are out working hard. They may not be the top comedian of the world. They may not be the top political analyst of the world. But you know something? They're real.
Mm-hmm.
We're real.
When keeping it real goes wrong.
That's right. So what's the name of those girls at this dance studio?
Paula and Diane.
Paula and Diane.
Let me tell you, they are incredible. They're incredible dancers.
Are they really?
Yep. Studio One in Brantford.
Oh, is that where they're from?
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. Do they give adult lessons like to adults?
I think they do have Zumba lessons.
They do have Zumba lessons?
Yes, they do have Zumba.
Okay.
But I think that's the extent of it.
I'm just kidding. I'm just teasing. They're going to be like, oh, my God, Tom, I thought he was a good guy. But he's like, oh, let's run for the hills.
They are so beautiful.
Yeah, and the personality's on top of it.
Exactly. Which, they have such good hearts.
Yeah, yeah.
That's what I tell my kids. If you're good on the inside, it comes out through
absolutely,
the outside.
Absolutely. I agree with that. And it's, I don't know.
You could see an ugly person coming a mile away lately, I swear.
You could feel it.
Yeah.
You could feel the aura.
Mm-hmm.
Not that I'm... No promotion, but you can feel the aura. People don't get that. I don't like to say the name of the joint, but there's just so much. There's so much going on that it's almost like you want to get away from it for a little while.
It's true.
Like, what can we talk about? We talk about politics. We talk about the complaints. How about my physical? I had a physical. My insurance gives me a physical. I go in, I think it's like once every 2 years.
Mm-hmm.
They allow me to have a physical because of my age limit. Now I'm allowed one every 2 years, when I used to be one every 5 years. But I got to the certain age bracket.
Mm.
That's when it gets scary. They're like, oh, you're that age now? Well, you're in the such and such category now. And
you
sit
need to
back.
Go in for regular maintenance.
Yeah, and then you're like, oh, really? So anyhow.
So how was it?
I had a physical, and I was expecting my doctor to give me the physical,
mm-hmm.
but the nurse practitioner gave me the physical.
Oh.
Was a female.
Was she attractive?
She was somewhat attractive, yes.
I always feel very uncomfortable when
she was younger than physical. She was younger than me,
mm-hmm.
somewhat attractive, and I didn't have a problem with it. As desperate as I am, I didn't have a problem with it. I sat back, and the very last thing was she put the rubber glove on, and she said, "Would you like to bend over the table, or would you like to lie on your side?"
Oh, God.
And all I could picture.
I didn't even need to picture that in my head.
I'm sorry.
I picture you lying on a table, like in a fetal position, butt cheeks. And
yeah. I said, no, I'll bend over the table. I just spread.
Oh, my God.
No. But she asked me, and all I could think of was like bending over the table.
Well, it's better to just touch your toes, right?
I would have been like, I would have had like these flashes of like, being in prison or something like that, and I couldn't do it.
So what happens? Like,
No, then she put the glove on.
And was she gentle?
She was gentle, and she told me a couple things I should do to make mm-hmm. it a little easier, and I got in the fetal position, and she did what she had to do, and then she started telling me that, you know, everything felt good inside there, and she goes, was it the same for you? And no, she didn't. But She said everything seems very healthy in there. She says, but my fingers really aren't as long as they, when I get in there, I can't get in there that far. And I was thinking, oh, she's going to call the doctor now, and he's going to come in.
This is outrageous. Like, you really have to go through this.
Yeah, so anyhow, then she was done, and I asked her a couple of questions, and I wanted to know if she wanted to go out for a cocktail.
No, you didn't.
No, I didn't.
I mean, how does she say, you know, it feels good, but my fingers are not long enough? Like, yeah. I know.
What, like, is that? We were having, like, conversation, and... But, you know, she made it comfortable. Like, you know, she touched me on my leg at one point, and and I didn't have a problem with that, you know.
Oh, my
so
gosh. Can you believe that?
I am. How desperate can you be to look forward to your physical? I mean, I don't know.
That's hilarious. You have to admit.
Well, it was an interesting experience. Because, but I'm at the age where I have to get the prostate checked, and she did my prostate exam. And, you know, it wasn't very enjoyable. All the people that are out there think of Tom, did you enjoy? No, I did not enjoy it.
I can't imagine.
But it was better than having the doctor and his big, long fingers up me. So, you know, what are you going to do?
I know, like some rough doctor come in, spread them.
Let me see. Look at Oompa Loompa says, size does matter. Did you get her number? You guys are bad. Did you ask her to hold your app?
That is funny.
Zura's mom. Now, this is funny. Did you ask her to hold you afterwards?
Woo, that's a good one.
Now, that's a good one. That's a good one.
Oh, that's so funny.
But I don't know.
Oh, my gosh.
So that was my experience in the doctor's office this weekend.
Well, how did everything else go? Like, besides
I got the results back, and everything's okay.
Good.
I'm healthy. I'm good.
So now you don't have to worry about an exam.
And all my other blood tests were good, which means I'm a healthy man.
Good.
In all aspects, you know, women, I'm a healthy man. You have nothing to worry about. I carry my papers with me. I'm going down a path I got to get away from. All right, let's get back to something else. Oh, man. Mitt Romney is now the leader of the Republican Party.
Herman Cain's getting up there. He's getting up there.
He won the Florida straw poll. You know, everyone pulls a straw, and Herman Cain came up top on the. So stupid, you know. But Herman Cain, he's a likable guy. He's a likable guy that's created his own business, created jobs for people, and a lot of people say, "Well, he doesn't know anything about foreign policy." He doesn't, you know. I don't think we need that right now.
Do you think Obama knows anything?
Yeah,
about
I know
foreign
exactly.
Policy? He just pissed off the Germans. He gave some speech, you know, to the Europeans saying you need to get your debt under control, and the Germans got so annoyed.
Really,
they
I didn't
like,
even know
how
about
absurd
that.
Absurd and arrogant for this spendthrift to tell us
you got
Germany,
that.
Who's freaking bailing out everybody in Europe.
The spendthrift.
I mean, that's the Germans were furious. But you don't hear about that on the news.
No.
Oh, if it was Bush, forget about it, Bush.
No.
The world hates us. But Obama, the Germans are calling him arrogant, absurd. He just, you know, let's put it under the rug.
You know what? I appreciate Stick Cam. It's a sponsored show tonight, but I appreciate what they're doing. But yeah, let's push it under the rug. Let's not talk about what a rotten thing he said.
Exactly.
You know.
Herman Cain, I think, would do a great job because to be a restaurateur, you have to be very diplomatic.
What we need for the next 4 years, you know, he'll have his people around him. Mm-hmm. He'll have his generals and his army staff and everybody, all the he'll have people to advise him as to what he should do in the foreign policy department.
Absolutely.
But what do we need here in the U.S.? We need jobs. We need to create jobs. And what do they say? They come out, folks, and understand, when I raise the volume of my voice, I'm doing it for the people. I'm doing it because I know everyone that is aggravated with what's being broadcast on national news, what's being broadcast in the mainstream media. They got all excited because unemployment numbers were in the 300,000 range rather than in the 400,000 range this week. So they're all talking about the economy might be rebounding. And I told you that my analogy, my it's like a pool, you know? You say, let's get the bad water out of the pool. How are we going to do it? You know what? I'm not going to get into my... No, I'm going... It's not going to make
sense. But the whole point point is that the job pool, in a way, is shrinking. Like, people have been on unemployment so long that they've been flushed right out of the system.
Right.
They're gone.
And pretty soon, the pool of unemployment, you know, it's like being in the pool and everybody's falling out of the bottom of the pool. All the people. Pretty soon, there's not going to be any more unemployed. Mm-hmm. It's going to look like the numbers are low. It's just because it's almost humanly impossible that there could be any more unemployed. So of course the numbers are going to start dropping. But they all say, oh, the economy's rebounding. What is there, 20 million or so? It's close to 20 million. What do you want? What do you want? The numbers just to keep falling so that it gets to 30 million, 40 million, 50 million? Eventually it's going to settle. It's all going to settle. But everybody gets this false idea that because the unemployment, the people for first-time unemployment claims, because it's dropping, the economy's getting better. It's such a false piece of information.
When they talk about retailing, it's bad. They talk about new home sales, it's bad. They talk about people having money, it's bad.
It's bad everywhere. Are people like, do they think we're friggin' blind? Do the politicians think we're stupid?
They do think
the ruling class and the working class, do they really look down on us from a high mountain and say those little pawns, those little peons don't know anything about what's happening in America?
They can't understand, it's too complicated.
Even though they live it every single day and they see what's going on and they're competent people, they don't know what's going on in the world. We know what's going on in the world. Hey, Frankie, give me another $16 muffin.
Woo!
Yeah.
Yeah,
we know what's going on in the world.
Yeah,
No,
I was just going to say, let me tell you, there would be no $16 muffins at my book signing.
No.
None. It
How
should be Betty Crocker, honey. Two for $3.
How dare they?
Myself.
And then Obama comes out and talks about the corporate jets all the time. The corporate jet owners. But he doesn't have any problem flying his wife over to
all
Spain.
Over the place.
He doesn't have any problem flying over to Martha's Vineyard for a vacation.
Two separate flights.
Right.
Two separate flights.
Yeah.
Government money.
He doesn't have any problem.
Together.
You know why? Because he's going to be a millionaire the rest of his life. He doesn't care.
Do you really think
he actually has the passion, like we do on this show, to help America? He's just trying to help his image, and that's about it. He wants to stick to his Democrat ideas because of the fact that he is a Democrat. He doesn't care. He's set for the rest of his life. Him, his family, and his kids, I don't blame him.
And his mother-in-law.
I don't blame him. Come on. If we're in the same situation, who's number one to take care of? Your family and the kids.
You know why I don't agree with that?
What?
Because George Washington, the greatest president ever, they offered him to be king, to be taken care of forever. And he's like, I did not fight in this war against the King of England with all these people who died under my command to become king. We're having a democracy. All right, so George Washington would have never, ever been like Obama. And that's what we need for a president, another George Washington. I'm serious.
I know. I hear where you.
I don't want freaking fat ass Chris Christie.
You don't like Chris Christie?
No, he's a stupid ass.
You don't like Chris Christie?
Absolutely not. He's a punk. I'm sorry, Chris Christie. You shouldn't be president.
But what about his speech at the Ronald Reagan Library?
Oh, I don't care. Speeches? How about Obama's speeches? All these beautiful things that come out of these
idiots'
mouths. I want the real deal. I want a George Washington. You know, it's true, Tom. All the beautiful things that come out of the idiot's mouth.
I don't want the fat ass.
No, I don't. I mean, not that I'm the thinnest person in the world.
No, he is a chubby.
But for Pete's sake, I gave birth to 4 children. I have no time to exercise. I see all these people running around exercising. I freaking wish I had time to go to the bathroom alone. Forget me being able to go work out. That's how I'm living. And then I'm going to have freaking Michelle Obama tell me what to do.
Yeah, I know. And who's the New York mayor? Bloomberg. He's coming out now and saying government should have a bigger role in what Americans are allowed to eat and what they what restaurants are allowed to serve.
Absolutely ridiculous.
That they need to have a bigger role in controlling health in the U.S. Does he think about what his words are actually saying? He's just trying to control everyone.
Well, he's so worried about that. Why doesn't he back Herman Cain, the restaurateur?
That's right.
Let's get Herman Cain, the restaurateur, to run the country. Is that what we're worried about? Everybody's diet? Herman Cain.
That's right.
I mean, come on. I am so sick of
Herman Cain.
Now Chris Christie, they're trying to pull. Imagine pulling him out of the woodwork.
Chris Christie.
You need like some operational machinery. But I'm so sick of it.
Yeah.
What the hell is this guy that they're acting like he's some genius? He hasn't really done much in the state of New Jersey. He's only been a governor for a few years.
I know. You know what it is? It's because he has a big mouth and he kind of tells it like it is. Like even when the hurricane was coming down the East Coast, the Hurricane Irene, mm-hmm. he got on there and said, "If you're on the Jersey Shore, get the hell out." And everyone's like, "Oh, wow, Christie, get him in the White House. Get him in the White House. He tells it like it is, you know?" That's what it was, you know?
I know. You're 100% right. You're right.
Because everybody heard that he was on the news, you know, on the New York stations and the New Jersey stations. If you're on the Jersey Shore now, the hurricane, get the hell out. And you're like, Governor Christie said, get the hell out. Let's get him in the White House. Oh, come on. He's going to make things happen. I mean, you know, right here, you big, you know, triple chin little...
I'm sorry, but I am not a Christie fan.
I just liked how he picked on Obama during the speech at the Reagan Library. But it was so, he was looking down at his sheets, and you know he was nervous and mm-hmm. everything else. Give him a couple more years. Let him lose some weight and see what he does at that
yeah,
time.
Yeah, exactly. But do really impress me and do something in the state of New Jersey before
we could become
president.
Look at this. We just get together for 60 minutes, and people think it's easy. People think, oh, well, let's watch the program. Folks, we may not have, like, dancing midgets in the back of us or anything
like
else.
Real-life Oompa Loompas.
Yeah, right, or real-life Oompa Loompas running around. But I'll tell you what. Here we are, a couple of people. How long ago did we meet? You were introduced to the program about, what, 8 months ago, or was it longer than that?
I think it was like in January, right after the
holidays. Yeah, about 8-9 months ago. Mm-hmm. And here we are coming on for 60 minutes, telling it like it is, getting a female's point of view, getting a male's point of view, or like when I cry and you get mad. No, but I'm saying the thing is that you get our point of view. We don't stop. Mm-hmm. You know, what are we going to do? We know that when we're on the air, we have to keep things rolling. We can't sit here. We can't be silent. We can't be like, well, what's the next thing we're going to talk about? Mm-hmm. You know, it's all real. It's passion. It's live, which makes it even more interesting. This is an interesting call. Uh-oh. Don't people know I'm on the air? I don't know if I should get this. This might be an important call for me, though.
I would just pick it up. See,
all right, hold on one second.
About the Toyota.
Hello? Hello? Hello?
I have your cat.
Oh, yeah, it must have been about the dealer plate. Yeah, good. Actually, you caught me at a bad time. I'm actually a television host, and we're just getting ready to go on the air. So can I give you a call tomorrow or something, or you could call me? I can't talk about it right now. I'll have to call you back. All right, bye.
You got to keep working. Listen, I'm sorry.
Do you think that I have to, I got the program going mm-hmm. now, but I don't stop. I have businesses. You know how many businesses I have? I have a business going. I have to take this call because if I miss the call, I can miss a Gino.
Exactly.
So what am I going to do? You know, but I think the people understand that here I am, a working man. Mm-hmm. I can't stop. It's 9:35 on the East Coast, which means it's 6:35 on the West Coast. But understand, we're from the East Coast right here. Mm-hmm. It's nighttime. It's 9:35. Normally, what would you be doing? I'd be kind of getting ready for bed, putting on a good movie, doing something because of my ball and chain that keeps me. No. But I'd be relaxing, getting ready for tomorrow. But mm-hmm. But here we are, spilling out our passion.
Yeah.
About what we feel is wrong in America. Are we going to make a change? Perhaps not. Are we going to get our voice heard? Yes, we are. Mm-hmm. Are we going to maybe change some people's mind that are living a liberal life like your publicist? I don't know. Who's the girl? Your illustrator?
My illustrator wants to come on and debate.
It would be nice because she could sit in that chair. It's a very comfortable setting mm-hmm. here, and we have. Where's the camera?
And she's actually very smart.
She looks like she is. And there's the camera of the guest chair. Mm-hmm. That is empty at the moment, but we can get you in there.
I say we should invite Barbara on.
Yeah, absolutely. We'll get her on here.
She wants to debate us because she, you know, she has a little tiny bit of the mental disorder. But
that's all right.
Just in the small time with the book signing,
I'd like to
talk to her a little bit.
I'd like to know how they think. I would like to know how they think. We need jobs for Americans, Tommy, but we don't know how to do that now that we are the minority. Yeah, well.
Yeah, because half the country doesn't pay taxes and doesn't contribute.
Exactly.
You know, so
and all they
like, well, what do I care?
And all they talk about is the rich paying their fair share. Well, I'll tell you what.
Oh, my gosh.
Let the rich pay their fair share, but let's halt all the wasteful government spending. How about, it's like, what do you do? Put the egg before the horse? Or, no, what's that?
The cart before the horse.
Yeah. Well, I mean, what comes first? The chicken or the egg? What comes first, you know? I mean, have the government stop their spending and say, hey, we controlled our spending, and maybe the wealthy will say, well, you know what? Now that you controlled your spending, let's give a little more now.
But you know what? The wealthy people give the lion's share. They're not paying their fair share. They're paying the lion's share of all of the income that is distributed to the government.
But like, it's the media and the Democrats that make you, that brainwash you.
And asses like Warren Buffett who lie, who just pay capital gains, pay yourself a salary,
How old is he?
Oh,
is he like 110 or 115?
And he's such a liar.
Ugly.
His own company is up an investigation
ugly man.
For not paying taxes.
He's an ugly man.
Because he's ugly on the inside.
That's right.
I'm telling you, he has no problem because he wants to keep us all down. I'm telling you, he doesn't want us to ever become rich. And I'm sick of it.
What are those girls' names again? The dancers? All right. I'm sorry. I just wish I could have hung out at the book signing a little more because then... You know, could have networked a little more.
It was a lot of fun.
Me and Oompa Loompa could have had a couple drinks. We could have laughed, told some jokes. We could have danced around, you know. But what are you going
to
do?
I have to say, it was so much fun because there were no kids around and everybody's partying.
Yeah.
That even the hockey coaches were
dancing. I could have danced with Zura's mom.
Oh, she's a great dancer.
Is she really?
Let me tell you, yeah. Mm-hmm.
I don't have much fun in life. This is my outlet right here. I'll tell you what, folks, don't go anywhere. We're going to take a 60-second break. We're going to be right back. We've got to run a couple of PSAs so that people understand the right and wrong things to do and give us a chance to catch a beverage. Not you, though. And let me see if we got it all set here. Oh, let me see. There we go. All right, folks, we'll be back in two and two, like they say.
Sir, have you been drinking this evening?
Sir, have you been drinking tonight?
Make no mistake, you will get caught and you will be arrested. Over the limit, under arrest.
Diana Page. Extraordinary children deserve extraordinary teachers, and extraordinary teachers are the backbone of strong American schools. Visit strongamericanschools.org to see what you can do to help, because our country's only as strong as its schools.
Extraordinary. there you are. Yeah, we were just trying to check things out. I know. Mm-hmm. I didn't hit the thing quick enough. But you know, I could be on it. I could be on it. I'm all right. I'm all right. You know, we're all right, just me and you doing this thing here. I got everything going. What's up? Big Judge, what's going on, man? This is a show of complaints. Mm-hmm. We got some new people watching the show tonight. The thing is, we complain about everyday life. We complain about anything from going to the doctors, mm-hmm. to President Obama, to the economy, to unemployment. Anything you want to talk about, we talk about it. Mm-hmm. But that's basically, it's I would say, a politically based show.
Yeah,
if
absolutely.
If people want the real deal here. But I don't know. The top 5% pay 59% of taxes.
That's ridiculous.
59%.
That's
because
ridiculous.
There's so many loopholes. Let me tell you something. If they did restructure the tax system and just made everybody pay, no matter if you make $1 million or you make $10, you pay that share. You make $10, you got to pay a buck. Mm-hmm. You make $1 million, you got to pay what you got
to
pay.
You know who wants to do that? Herman Cain. He has that 999. That, where it's 9% business flat tax, 9% individual tax. Imagine 9%
but
individual.
The thing is,
money
is we have. Still need to create jobs. That's
and
the
that's
thing.
And that's how we do it, because if you're only paying 9% business tax,
right.
you'd be able to hire people.
Right. But the thing is not only do we have to create jobs, people have to start earning money so they can spend money. We have to create jobs. We have to fix the housing crisis. That's where it lies. For if you do the statistics on Google or whatever else, every house that is built or sold creates jobs.
Absolutely,
it does. It creates jobs. And the problem is when this housing crisis hit, that's what happened with all the crazy unemployment and people going bankrupt and everything else. It's because of the housing crisis. It's because of the greedy little Chris Dodd right here in Connecticut and Barney Fag Frank. Because of those people, that's the reason this country is in the mess that they've actually single-handedly ruined this country. I'm not going to get into that. I'm not going to get all the statistics back. I'm not going to get all the information. It's just they did, all right?
And then they passed that overregulation bill right before they left.
Chris
Dodd, right before he left, like he didn't ruin things enough. Yeah. He passes that bill with all this regulation that now people can't even qualify to refinance their mortgages because they don't fit into that tiny little thing.
It's Democrats again.
Yes.
Saying that even with the mortgages, let's give mortgages to people mm-hmm. who really can't afford
right,
it.
Right, because if you don't, you're going to get fined.
Right.
So the banks are like, I'm going to pay. If I don't, I'm going to pay.
So Bank of America says, well, I'll tell you what, since we're in such a crisis, you're going to have to pay $5 to use a debit card. Everybody's got to pay $5 to help us get out of a mess, even though you weren't responsible for getting us into this mess. You're going to be responsible for getting us out of the mess, and that's exactly how government is. Government is, even though the citizens of America aren't responsible for getting it's the wasteful spending of the government, but the citizens of America are going to be responsible for getting us out of debt. Just like here in Connecticut.
Mm-hmm.
What does he say? The governor, he says, even though citizens of Connecticut are not responsible for getting us into debt, with the taxes we're going to have on services that never had taxes before, we're going to raise the tax rate because you, the citizen of Connecticut, is going to be responsible. There are some people, though, that live in Connecticut that say they don't mind paying the extra money to help us
who
get out of debt.
People?
I know. I don't know where their mind is.
I mean, who are
I've had people come through my store that say, I don't mind paying the tax as long as it helps our state get out of debt.
They must have a lot of money.
I just think their thought process... you know, are people mental? Like, are there some people that just have a mental lobe in their brain?
Absolutely.
Like Janine Garofalo
with her
mental lobe claiming. Do you know Janine Garofalo claims that Herman Cain, she said she wouldn't be surprised if the Tea Party either bribed or hired with pay Herman Cain to become a Republican because of the color of his skin.
She's so...
And she's saying that the Tea Party people are racist when she got into a racist comment,
exactly,
not even
totally
knowing
racist.
Because her frontal lobe is so freaking mm-hmm. stupid and so freaking earthy
that's
that she
right.
can't even realize that she needs to take a shower and change her underwear once in a while. She's disgusting.
She does. She looks like she's like one of those kids in college who they finally away from their parents and they're not around to say, you need to take a bath.
Yeah,
you need
I know.
To comb your hair.
Yeah.
You need to do your laundry.
You need to wash your hair with shampoo so it doesn't look like a greasy slick that you'd cook french fries in.
I know.
That's Janine Garofalo. That she used to have Janine the cat Garofalo. Glass, you know, the old goofy thing.
And I think she goes for that look on purpose, too, is the scary yeah. part because she's so ugly.
Let's see what a few people have to say to us here. Budge Judge, a bid judge. Yes, Obama has crippled the United States.
Mm-hmm.
Thanks, Democrats. Chicago Dave, not a fan of Kane. 9% national sales tax.
Well, you know what? In a way, I agree with you. But part of the problem is that a lot of people, like Warren Buffett, probably spend millions of dollars on crap, and he has all these tax loopholes.
On crack?
No,
oh,
on
no,
crap.
Crap. Okay.
On crack when he's hitting the pipe. No, but you know what the problem is that in some ways, that's the only way to get illegals to pay taxes.
Right.
To get people who don't pay any taxes, like
you're right.
buy stuff.
You're right.
But I agree with you. I'm not a fan of the 9% sales tax either. Because then you're looking at, what, like 17%?
The housing crisis started the problem, but it's the Obama policies that are preventing the recovery. Absolutely.
Absolutely. It's too much overregulation.
Yes. Oompa Loompa. I always do that. Oompa Loompa said.
Oompa Loompas.
But, yeah. I mean, Gabagool joined the room. What's up, Gabagool?
Hey, Gabagool.
See, that's the thing. A lot of people that are watching us locally here in Brantford right now are saying, Gabagool, what is he looking over to the left? It's internet. It's internet television. A lot of people that are watching us are watching. The people in Brantford that are watching us, the show is taped.
Yeah.
The people who are watching us right now on the internet, it's live.
Live.
So a lot of people are probably in the local Brantford area saying, well, how can we watch the show live? We like watching the taped show, but we like to really watch it live so that we can interact with you. Well, I'll tell you what, there's something called a website, mm-hmm. and it's right here across the bottom of the screen. Write it down, go get a pencil and paper. It's not that hard to remember. If you go on the internet on Thursday nights at 9 o'clock on the East Coast, if you're in the West Coast, it's 6 o'clock.
Mm-hmm.
Every single Thursday night we are live, and thanks to the people over at the Stick Network. Well, I'm not even looking at anything. And sometimes I talk, and I'm looking at talking to the picture.
Oh, really?
Yeah, but let me see.
Let's put the phone number on too. Maybe they can call in next week. Like,
next
write
week,
it down,
yeah. Then. I don't know what's wrong with my speaker, with the speaker on this phone.
I don't know.
That's pretty weird. Well, if someone wants to try to call, and we could try to get you on the air. Let me see. But there's something wrong with the speaker on the speakerphone. It's not popping on, and I do not know why. I do not know why.
Well, I mean, you know, it was Charlie live from Oktoberfest.
Yeah.
He called before. Boy, he sounded like he was
He does, but he knows call. He knows the hotline number. So I was able to get him in there. All right, let's see here. What else we got? Bid Judge says true. Gabagool, no wonder the Northeast is dying.
It's true.
Why is that?
It's all the overtaxing, I think.
Yeah.
I mean, when you look at Texas, where they have such, like, no state income tax, that's incredible.
Let me see. What else we got? High five. The mental disease is called liberalism.
Mm-hmm.
I had that on my website even before that became a term, I think. I have a whole thing on my website about liberalism.
It's like an entitlement mentality. Like,
yeah.
I have a story, but I don't know if I should say it.
All right. Why not? Well, you feel it'll offend some people?
It's going to offend one person. I don't know if I should say it.
Oh, no.
But it's the perfect entitlement.
If it's a viewer.
No, yeah. No, it's not a viewer. But it's just like the perfect entitlement situation where people just feel like if things don't go their way and they make mistakes, somebody else has to come and rescue them. And they don't have to suffer the consequences of, like, you know, losing things or not doing certain things they should be doing.
It's just like having mommy and daddy with you forever. It's you never have the chance to grow up and have responsibility.
Exactly.
And that's what happens with people who get into that system of government assistance, of welfare. Do you know how hard some people work at making sure they can receive those benefits?
Oh, absolutely.
If they took that energy and put it into opening up a business or putting it into working for someone, they'd go right up the ladder so fast. but they don't realize it. They want to make sure they're getting something for nothing. And there are people that are like that, and there's nothing you can do to change them.
Well, when you have the president who preaches all this fear,
exactly.
I mean, he gives you so much uncertainty that even if, let's say, you have that drive,
right.
you get too scared. You're like, no, that's too scary. I
right.
can't do it. I can't.
He used to make speeches with his inexperience. I can remember speeches. There's a time when people have made a little too much money, and it's time to... Are you kidding me? Like if you work hard and you achieve the American dream and you make so much money, the government's going to take it out of your pocket because you became successful?
Yeah, because they know how to spend it better.
I understand there's people suffering, and yeah, let's give them the benefit they need to survive. Mm-hmm. But don't take advantage of the system. Well, Tom, let me tell you something. I've been around people that take advantage of the system every mm-hmm. single day. They'll do what they can, they'll make up stories, they'll do everything they can to make sure that they're gonna get a benefit out of the system. And as proud as I am, and I'll tell you right now, if you wanna look it up, ever since I started becoming a working man at mm-hmm. 16 years old, I have never once collected unemployment. I have never once collected government assistance. I've never once collected any assistance from the state on welfare. But then again, I've never been married and have kids, so.
But you know what, Tom? Honestly, that isn't even, it's such a small percentage, but when you have the government giving over $700 million to another solar company after they gave over $500 million to one that just went bankrupt, it's like, wait a minute, this isn't about helping people, this is about you getting rich, Nancy Pelosi's brother-in-law.
I know.
You know, that they want to be so rich, and I mean,
it's
$700 million?
It's all... They're all out for themselves.
Absolutely.
Politicians.
With government money.
Absolutely. Nancy Pelosi's brother.
I know.
I mean, come on.
How many jobs it's going to create?
What, like 3?
45 permanent jobs for $700 million? Are you kidding me? 45 permanent jobs and a few construction jobs, like 600 construction jobs, but then they'll all get laid off and collect unemployment for months after they're done building it, and then they'll hope another politician will build something else that won't work.
I wonder how much money they're going to be getting, what their annual salary is. $700 billion.
$700 million.
$700 million. Yeah. And I wonder what their salaries are going to be for 45 employees. Let's do 45 divided by 700 million. That's
just
a pretty good paycheck.
Just write everybody a check. But you know what makes me so crazy, Tom? We should be outraged as Americans.
It is.
And then the Tea Partiers get crazy. Go, no, we're going to protest this. The spending's out of control.
Someone's,
and we're the bad guys?
Someone's got it. Someone's really got to clean this country up.
Come
like
on.
You said, Governor, you said we need a strong individual that's going to make something happen. Mm-hmm. I'm a little disappointed in Rick Perry. I'm beginning to wonder if he's going to be able to get it in somebody's face and say, this has got to change.
I'll tell you one thing. If they tried to diss Sarah Palin, she's a lot tougher than Rick Perry looked that day in the debate.
Absolutely.
You know?
Absolutely. 99% college professors, liberalism.
Yeah.
You're right. You're
it's
right.
It's indoctrination.
It is.
When you go, I cannot believe, like, when you really research history,
yep.
how the founding fathers did not get indoctrinated. That's why they were able to build this great country.
That's right. That's right. They didn't have, you're right. But when kids get educated, that's exactly what happens to them. They get into this. I know somebody who teaches history, and I don't know him. I don't really care for him. But man, is he so far to the left.
Yeah.
But every time I meet someone, not your typical teacher, but when you meet a career, like someone who's just professors, or they're all liberal.
They're
I can't figure
liberal.
It out.
It's
I can't figure it out.
I once went to a birthday party with all these Yale professors, and all they did was talk about how they couldn't wait to get that, what is it called, where they could go play golf all day because they're supposed to write a book and do
legalized
this, do
mafia.
Oh, the government. It's
yeah,
true, the
exactly,
IRS.
Zuris. Especially when you have your own business. Let me tell you, you want to talk about having your own business where you have to deal with employees and payroll mm-hmm. and taxes and everything else. When I don't think the average politician really understands how much work you and how much of your life you give up when you own your own business. I don't think they have,
they don't have a clue.
And
imagine if they did.
It makes me sick. But we gotta have politicians. When is it gonna change? It's like, how much can you talk about it before you get so sick you just want to vomit? I mean, it's absolutely amazing.
Well, and that's why the Tea Party people take to the streets. Because they're like, no, we don't want you giving $700 million to another solar company. Okay?
Yeah.
People are hurting right now. Why don't we figure out a way to help other Americans and not spend the money on Nancy Pelosi's brother-in-law?
Your own business equals weekly prostate checkups. Zara's mom.
I got to tell you, owning your own business is so stressful.
Oh,
I mean, I have never been more frightened than I was last week worrying about having a successful book launch.
Right.
Because it's like, this is my project.
Yeah.
I got to get it out there.
Absolutely.
Now, I've worked hours and hours and hours and hours for no pay.
We were one of the first ones there, and I could tell you were a little like, hi, Tom. But you were looking around like, all right, when's everyone else going to get here?
Okay, somebody's here.
I know.
It's a big empty
room. But all of a sudden, they all started coming in. Even the dance teachers. I don't know. Were they from Brantford? They live in Brantford. Yeah.
Yeah, they're fantastic.
Yeah, yeah. They seem like nice people. That's about it.
I can't believe that time went this
fast. And I'm tired.
Past.
You know, I'm going to go home. I'm going to want to watch some kind of show, but I can't watch every channel now because I have to go to Comcast and get that stupid little box. There's some channels, like, did you get the little box that you're supposed to get?
No, I have to get that box. I bet you that's why I'm having so much trouble.
Yeah, when you change, there's like a bunch of channels, you just get snow. It's just absolutely nothing. And then, but I could still watch Storage Wars.
Storage Wars?
Yeah, they bid on storage units. You ever see that show?
No.
Oh, you didn't? Oh, it's kind of fun.
No, I never watched that.
Oh, that's good. How about The X Factor? What do you think about that so far?
I haven't watched that either.
Yeah. I don't really care for it that much. But, Tom,
there's only one show. Tom's show.
Zura's mom. I'm going to read Zura's mom's comment.
Oh, what did she say?
Tom, you're so much more handsome in person.
Ooh! I know. Everybody was so excited to see you.
I was pretty excited to be there. I wish I could have stayed. I'm the kind of person that... I'm a kind of a fun person. But I couldn't explore my funness. Darlene, what's up, Darlene from Florida? Where you been?
Hey, hi, Darlene.
I'm in the business. Don't get me started on Storage Wars, haha. But I do watch it for research purposes.
Wow.
Chicago Dave goes to those storage places. I wonder if I've seen them. Storage Wars is a hoot.
Now I'm going to have to check it out.
I know.
So many of our viewers watch it. I have to watch it too.
Well,
I can't believe an hour went by that fast.
I wonder if we were entertaining tonight. I think we were. I think we did all right. You know? With not much preparation. Tonight was one of those nights we didn't prep all that much. And there wasn't that much tabloidy stuff going on in the world.
No
Charlie Sheens of the world right now. But we're still itch-baying our messages. So, I don't know if that made sense. But anyhow, folks, thanks for tuning in. Cheryl, thanks for hanging in there, babe. I hope to see you soon. Zura's mom, see you soon. Oompa Loompa, no. Minnesota, Chicago Dave, Bid Judge, High Five, and all the other people in Stick Network, thanks for tuning in. And if you're in Brantford, Connecticut, thanks for watching. Don't forget, if you see us on the street, just come up and say hi. Lisan, thanks for hanging out. Everything worked out good. I think we did all right tonight.
I know. I had a great time.
Yeah, I did too. And I had a good time at your book signing. I think it was quite a success.
Thank you.
Good for you. And just keep the ball rolling. And good luck in the Carolinas. You're going somewhere pretty soon,
yep.
I understand.
In weeks.
All right. All right. This is it.
Bye, guys.
I'm going to try to keep this one on time so I don't have to edit that much. I get tired of editing. Let me see if I got it right here. All right. Here it is. All right, everybody. We'll see you later. We'll see you next Thursday. Hope I said goodbye to everybody. Good night, all.